The International Institute for Sustainable Development, IISD, has come up with the State of Global Environmental Governance 2022. The document published in February 2023 provides an overview of progress made in global environmental governance in the year 2022. There are hopeful stories and there are tragedies also. Editor Jennifer Allen, a PhD, a strategic advisor and team leader with Earth Negotiations Bulletin as well as a lecturer at Cardiff University, writes, "If, like me, you are an environmental policy nerd or, more kindly, passionate about protecting the natural world, 2022 was a feast." She further describes UNEP's use of crisis as act, citing the example of chemicals in our bodies threatening children's rights and nature loss infringes on indigenous people's rights. She emphasizes our very human rights are at stake. On the bright side, in 2022, the UN General Assembly recognized the human right to a clean, healthy, and sustainable environment. Jane Allen also underlines other bright spots. A climate election brought a new greener government to power in Australia. Brazil elected Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva as president, giving rise to new hope for the Amazon. The United States passed the Inflation Reduction Act, an odd name for a potentially powerful piece of climate legislation. In 2022, California banned forever chemicals or per- and polyfluoroalkyl substances PFAS in products. And there are many affected products. Seriously, everything from non-stick cookware to firefighting foams. Also, in good chemicals news, the ozone hole continues to shrink. In the year, there are over 634 decisions just in the 10 COPs and MOPs, that is the highest decision-making bodies for treaties. Many were biodiversity. The Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna sites accounted for over half the yearly total with a record 365 decisions. Major milestones punctuated these sometimes routine but vital decisions. Despite the geopolitical and economic winds blowing against global cooperation, more wetlands are protected. New chemicals added to the Stockholm and Rotterdam conventions. More species benefiting from the protections offered by science. Biodiversity negotiations epitomize resilience in the face of the challenges of the past 2 years. After delays, online meetings, and moving venue from China to Canada, the UN Biodiversity Conference adopted the Kunming Montreal Global Biodiversity Framework, GBF. This framework will guide further biodiversity policy. It replaces the Aichi biodiversity targets, most of which were not met. This time around, the targets are more comprehensive, specific, and time-bound. Guided by a vision of living in harmony with the nature by 2050. The GBF includes 4 overarching goals and set up 23 targets to be reached by 2030. Even the World Trade Organization, that is WTO, did its part for biodiversity. After over 2 decades of talks, WTO members clinched a deal on fisheries subsidies. The treaty curbs subsidies to illegal, unreported and unregulated fishing, fishing of overfish stocks, fishing on the high seas outside the control of regional fisheries management organizations. With this agreement, governments have gone a long way towards fulfilling the mandate of SDG 14.6. There is more work to do, but it's a start. It was not a clean sweep of significant decisions in 2022. Work remains to finalize key climate reports and address the future of chemicals management and high seas biodiversity. Important talks took place in 2022. There is hope for global cooperation to address the flood of plastic polluting land and water. The process, which is ambitiously set to conclude in 2024, had its first meeting in November 2022 with an exchange of views on the treaty's scope. Early talks also began on establishing a science policy panel on chemicals and waste to prevent pollution. Many hope this body will help raise the profile of chemicals and waste issues as the IPCC and IPBES have done for climate change and biodiversity. In 2022, loss and damage finally achieved institutional depth. Beyond recognition and technical support, there will be funding arrangements. Nature-based solutions gain breadth. The ideas spread across decisions of various treaties, not always smoothly but successfully. The concept of nature-based solutions, NBS, pioneered by the IUCN, is 20 years old. The heart of the idea is that healthy ecosystems can achieve other environmental and social goals. Rather than technologies or built infrastructure, nature can help us reduce carbon emissions, adapt to a warmer world, be protected from storm waters, enhance farming biodiversity, and many more. NBS is a powerful idea that could reorient our approaches to environmental policy, but it only appeared in global decisions in 2022. Performance reviews will be a theme of 2023. The year could bring clarity and perhaps hope. As the adage goes, sunlight is the best disinfectant.